All right, so let's say you're standing on top of a building and you throw a ball straight down to the ground, all right? If the ball goes 25 meters in 2 seconds, and the speed of the ball is represented by V of T equals 9.8 T plus V naught, what is the initial speed of the ball? Now, it's gonna be 30 problems like this on the homework tonight, so y'all pay attention while I walk this one through, okay? Mr. Davis, Franklin.
Huh?
I don't think your headphones are required for taking notes. Could you put those away, please?
Well, actually, I'm not taking notes. I'm just on Ableton working on this beat right now, so.
Oh, wow. So we're in your studio. That's where we are right now. For some reason, I thought this was my class.
Look, all due respect, but I already know how to do that problem, so, you know.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay, look, first of all, you're never in this class. And secondly, you never pay attention either. But somehow you know integral calculus. You can do this?
I mean, I do have a textbook I can read.
So I'm guessing you'd have no problem coming up here and solving this for the whole class, huh?
Look, man, I don't know why you singling me out like this. Gerald over there don't ever be paying attention either.
All right, well, here's the thing. Look, Gerald is here every day, unlike you. And when he's working on other stuff, it's for his other classes. Meanwhile, you're just working on BS.
Okay, I'm getting like real hard hater vibes from you right now.
I'm just being real, all right? If you really want to secure your future, you're going to have to do a lot more than just make music, okay?
Okay, so if I go up there and I solve their problem, what you going to do? Give me no homework?
Yeah, why not? If you can solve it, which I don't think you can.
So what if I do it in a rap? What about that?
Oh, now you're just trolling. I love to see that.
You don't think I can do it?
No, I don't.
Put some on it.
If you can rap a solution to this problem, I'll give you no homework for a month.
Bet.
Look, we set the problem up, simple to do. V of T is the function, the physical rules that the ball gon' follow when it falls. So we gotta solve for the slow or the hard throw. V naught is the speed that it got initially when you dropped it. Earth rules, so the force of gravity puts an extra 9.8 T in your pocket. Stop, watch it. Naturally, T zero at the top tip. 25 meters down and we stopped it. Since we know that 2 seconds on the clock tick, we got everything that we need far as optics. Integrate speed and we get distance. Left side 25 this instance. Right side, just describe how far it went since first drop. I never flop, never miss hints. Do the D in the next moment. First turn gets the chop coefficient. Add that, then you add 1 to the exponent. I know the power rule cause we took a test on it. Go ahead and plug up all the numbers for your T's. Never multiply before you square parentheses. Zero's in the right bracket so you know it's easy. Only thing we got left is solving for the V. 19.6, take it out of 25, gets you 5.4 equals 2V. 9, then divide by 2 and it's 2.7. That's the speed of the ball and it's meters per second.
How'd I do? Was that close?
That is correct.
Are you sure?
Yes, yes, congratulations.
I appreciate it. Hey, look, I'm gonna just go ahead and take off. I'm kind of hungry right now. I'm gonna see y'all on test day.
Hey, whoa, wait a minute. Hey. Oh, good. I was hoping you'd still be here.
Yeah, gotta be a little late for the golf course, but you said it was important. So
it is important. Yeah, I got a new recruit for your team.
Oh, is this the kid?
Franklin, this is Professor Holloway.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
Holloway's the head of the science department, and he also runs the quiz bowl team I told you about.
Fitzhugh says you're pretty sharp, and the team's got an opening. Have you done quiz bowls before?
Your first name is Fitzhugh?
Just answer his question.
I heard there was prize money. I'll go in.
It's sponsorship money that you'd be splitting with the university, but yes. And listen, don't think this is just some quick cash grab, okay? I know Northbridge is a community school, but our quiz bowl team is nationally competitive with multiple championship wins. We got more trophies than Duke. Fitz, tell me this isn't just some hack opportunist. This kid for real?
I vouch for him. I wouldn't waste your time.
Okay, look, I need someone who can be an asset to the team. Is that you?
I think so.
You gotta be quick on your feet. You gotta have a deep understanding of math, physics, and the geological record. Can you handle that?
I'll give it my best shot.
Your best shot.
Listen, if I show up, I'm gonna show up to win, okay? I don't do anything halfway.
Good to hear. Fitz also tells me you have some kind of mnemonic element to your solve process. You said like a musical memory trick?
It's just how I talk my way through a solution.
What, like a rap? Splitnation?
If you want to call it that, sure.
And I've seen it. It's pretty effective.
Okay, whatever you're talking about is not relevant in competition. What matters is having the answer to the question before the time expires. No time for gimmicks, no time for games. Just let me know if you can arrive at a solution accurately and quickly.
I can do it.
You can. Yeah, how about I give you a sample question right now?
No, go ahead.
Okay, you're an astronaut on your way back from deep space. You're almost home. A huge CMA, magnetic solar storm, knocked out your ship's autopilot, so you gotta run your rockets manually. You're lined up for your entry corridor, but you're going way too fast, 40 kilometers a second. You gotta cut 80% of that speed or the ship is gonna smash and explode against the atmosphere. So how long do you burn retro rockets that dump 120 kps with an exhaust velocity of 3,000 meters per second?
And what's the full mass of the ship?
1.7 million kilos.
Cool.
So I'm assuming that the crew's not burnt to a crisp from a coronal mass ejection. Plus I got an issue with the simplification and things you ignore when you ask the question, but no worries, I got the rest. Slow the ship down in the past test. Decelerating is one thing, but if after that we can make it through the corridor, that's impressive. Force on the rocket ain't lost to me. Gotta find a way to chop my velocity. If I'm wrong, I'm a wrecking ball. Got the crew, got the ship coming neck and ball. Use a Newton equation to check it off. Got the second law, my beck and call. All I gotta do is fit the right values to the vectors and now we inspect the model. Right, so showing I'm top speed, gotta slow down, turning 40 kph into 8,000, burning up mass on the retro, 120 inch the weight, but I need a breakdown. Find the relation, use a rocket equation. When you read it, say how, U times natural log at a fraction of mass from finish below the weight now. Plug in the V's, we can split up the log. It helps when you ISO the M that you know, from the one that we saw. Hit a sexy flip in rotation, can't text you if we don't make it. Got the MF term at the log box with the exponential notation. Now that we know about the mass at the end of the burn, we can look at the burn rate function. So you take the burn rate times a variable t and subtract from the mass at the onset. Left side's m sub f. What time do we got? What we want left? Looks like this thing gonna burn 131.82.317 seconds.
So sustained retro rocket engine burn for like 3.66 hours, just about, slowing down the ship and exhausting about 93% of the total mass. I'd have to double check that. But
in competition, you get 10 minutes to solve a problem like that. You did that in like two.
That's because the beat was so fast.